Bible says that we should love our neighbors as ourselves, and that there's no greater love than that a man should lay down his life for his brother. Dad and his friends considered the Waurani, even though they didn't know them, to be their neighbors. And that's what they came here to do. His dad killed here, but Kathy and I were baptized along with Iniwa and one of the young ladies that Kathy used to play with. But I wanted my kids to see that the beach is a real place here where Dad was killed. And I want them to know that God's love is real, and that what He calls us to, if we give ourselves to Him, that He'll see to it that finally it makes sense, especially in eternity's values.
When our grandchildren came up with the idea of our whole family going down to Ecuador together, I thought, boy, wouldn't that be incredible? And then immediately thought, no, that it can't happen. Everybody organizing their schedules, so many kids getting passports. We had a big group to get to Ecuador, and going to Quito was one thing. Getting to show was another thing, but then the multiple challenges of getting, you know, me, an incomplete quadriplegic, into the jungles, that just was a huge barrier to get over. Yeah, it was just very humbling to see all the special preparations that they had to make to allow me to be part of this dream last visit to Ecuador. When we were, Jenny and I were living in Ecuador, Rick LaBeouf loaned us his Cessna bush plane, and I think I made 3,300 flights in that little plane. Most of them, you know, out of one short jungle strip, over a ridge or two or three, and rivers, and then boom, down into the jungles again. But this time it was going to be a new experience for me. To take off from Shell, and as we flew out over the jungles, you know, I was recognizing airstrips that I used to land at, and Gala was telling me, well, we don't use that airstrip anymore because now the road goes there. And you know, as we passed into Waurani territory, we were following the Ewenguno, or in Spanish, the Curaray River, which I could see Toñampare, the little village and a special place in the river where the river's forced to go straight. That's where Dad found that longer sandbar where he landed, and where he and Roger and Pete and Ed and Jim were killed. And then it was time to let down into Sapino, and to see how much work the Waurani, and especially Minkai's family, had gone to carve that little jungle airstrip out of that dense Amazon rainforest. It was just, you know, brought so many memories back. I would have rather trade places with Gallo and gotten a chance to fly that plane in, but
thank you.
when we finally got up to the camp after, oh, maybe half an hour in this winding river, we pulled up to the bank and looked up, and there was Kimo, the first warrior who decided that he wanted to walk this new trail. His wife Dawa, who is my considered to be my tribal grandmother, she accepted the gospel even before Aunt Rachel and Aunt Betty went in to live with the Waurani.
Hey, Dawa, Buddha. Dube
Ponda
Baba.
Dube
Ponda
Baba.
It was very, very special to get to spend day and a half with the Waurani, and we heard a week later that Dawa had died. So to get to see my tribal grandmother one more time, the last time, that was in Kimo and Minkai and Dewey and Ompore and Epa and Tomo and Kangawanto and a bunch of the young people that are now taking more and more responsibility. To see them with all of our kids, it just was, it was almost an emotional overload for me, in a happy way, in a very happy and moving way. Jenny said, when kids would say, "Hey, Peepa, did you get to go hunting when you're down here?" And they had gone fishing, and they told me, and I said, "Yeah, did you catch any catfish?" And they had, and those are really, really good eating. And then they had speared a little caiman, and yeah, Jenny just kept saying to the kids when they'd say, "And did you get to do this?" And, "Oh man, we got to watch them do this." And Jenny would say, yeah, isn't that amazing? Then she'd turn to me and say, "Boy, we've had a lot of really incredible experiences in our life, haven't we? And to think that God would have written this, written little Stevie Saint and wonderful, beautiful, sweet Jenny into this story that now is two generations beyond us. Very incredible, very, very moving. I think it didn't really hit me until we were on our way back to Quito that that this was the last trip, you know. It's so easy to think that life just goes on. I have the advantage with, you know, my the crippling effects of quadriplegia and days when I can't even get out of bed and pain is so terrible. I've realized more than most people at this age how short life is, but it really came home as we were heading back up in the mountains getting ready to fly back to the States that, you know, that whole foundation of my life in Ecuador and all those friends that we can't hang on to that. It's except to pass it on to the next generation and trust life to them and then to trust them to lead the next generation after them and I just realized that raising children and then children raising children, those values are so easy to be lost, but to realize that our children and our wonderful daughters-in-law, think of them more as daughters, that they have taken the gospel into their lives and believe it and live it, and now are passing it on to our grandchildren. I don't know if mom and dad can see from heaven, could see, but I just kept thinking, boy, I hope they can see. I hope they can see their great-grandchildren now endorsing the truths that they believed and that they went to Ecuador to share with people that never knew, and that the Waurani and staff there at ITEC Ecuador have adopted for their own. I just realized what a blessing it is that even our grandchildren, mom and dad's great-grandchildren, are adopting the precepts and the values that mom and dad went to Ecuador to share with people who had never heard. This whole trip was what we call, Ginny and I call, a happy, sad event. So happy to have been able to do it, and so sad that this is really the last time, short of a miracle.
Soon we'll come to the end of life's journey, and perhaps we'll never meet anymore. Till we gather in heaven's bright city, far away on that beautiful shore. If we never meet again this side of heaven, as we struggle through this world and its strife, there's another meeting place somewhere in heaven, by the side of the river of life, where the roses bloom forever, and where separation comes no more. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I will meet you on that beautiful shore.